Well, hi folks, 10th of April now, Easter Monday, so it's time to get my potatoes in the containers planted out, as usual. So I've got my chitted potatoes here, I've got Nicola and the Blue Danube again. These were all kept from my own potatoes last year. Nothing too difficult about that. All I did was when I lifted them, the final crop, I just left some in the porch as they were all year. So they've been just like that for 6 months, just left them and they've been absolutely fine. So another bit of money saved. So what I'm going to be using are, as usual, these 30 litre pots. And if you notice at the bottom, I've drilled some more holes for added drainage and also for more access for the roots of the plant to get into the soil. Because as you know, I plant them into the soil as well as being in pots. So the more holes you can have, the more chance the roots will get into the soil and get more nutrients and more moisture. I'm just going to be using bog standard compost this year again. This year it looks particularly rubbish, if I can show you that. It's just all wood fibre by the looks of it. So what I've decided to do this year, because I found a lot of molehill soil, I'm going to add maybe about just less than 10% volume of my own topsoil that I've collected from the field. So just like one of those 2 litres, probably less than 10%, about 7%, just to give it a bit more body, because last year I grew it in the same compost, but it did have added Johninnies in it, and I had the best crop of potatoes ever, so I thought this might replicate that mix somewhat. And the fertiliser I'm using again, as always, is Blood Fish and Bone. And I also use a little bit of this organic potato fertiliser because it's high in potash, and potash benefits tubers and things like that. So I'll just give it a small handful of that to each pot as well. So I'll just show you how we do it. Couldn't be easier. I'm just going to sort of half fill this pot first with the compost. It's pretty rubbish looking stuff. Mind you, it looked rubbish last year, but it grew absolutely fantastic stuff. So it's not what it looks like, it's what results you get. So again, I'm going to add some of this. Never added my own soil to my compost, so just going to add a bit of that. It's not a great deal. And also to that, I'm going to add just a small handful of Blood Fish and Bone, sprinkle that on, and an even smaller handful of that, probably not even half an ounce. And I'm just going to give that a really good mixing up, getting all the soil and the fertiliser well mixed in. You can't actually even tell I've put any soil in now I've mixed it up, but I know there is some in, so it should give it a bit more oomph. And then what I'm going to do with these, with the new potatoes or the early potatoes, make sure which is which, that's the sarpos. I'm going to plant 3 in each 30 litre pot, so that's 1 seed potato for every 10 litres. And the way I do that is, I'm just going to push it into the pot so it's about an inch from the bottom, spread them out, so that's 3 in there, quite close to the bottom. And then basically I'm going to top this pot almost to the top, not completely to the top, because if they do start to sprout through the soil, then the leaves start coming through when there's still some frost about. I like to leave about an inch or two below the surface so I can top that up later, but just in case they're up, then I can cover them in compost and that'll protect them from the frost. So probably only gives you another week's worth of protection, but it can be all that matters really. So that's not far off. Again, just add a bit more of this. Another half of one of those. Another handful of Blood Fish and Bone. Another small dollop of that. And again, just give it a good mix. I'm not going to water these now, because there's no point in watering them if it's cold, because they'll just end up rotting off and it's going to throw it down in the next few days with rain, so there's not really much point. They'll get enough moisture from the rain, and there is some moisture in the compost to get them going. So then what we do with that is, you can see behind me, Oops, I don't fall over. What I've done, I've made a trench. I'll get an empty pot and show you. I've made a trench, the width of the pot, about 3 inches deep. And heat the soil up in the middle and to the sides. So then what I do is, I'll do this at the end, place my pots in the row like so, and then there's enough soil at the edges to heap up, that'll cover all the drainage holes, so then when any roots do come out, they'll grow straight into the soil and not be open to the elements, open to the air. So it's just a way of guaranteeing that the soil will be in contact with the roots and they get the best results. So we'll get on and plant those. I've got a bit of an experiment to do later on. I'm doing that with two more pots where I'm going to grow some in pure molehill soil and sharp sand mix, because the price of compost is getting so ridiculous now. I thought, I've got unlimited sharp sand and I've got unlimited molehill soil, so I'll give that a test. I'll show you how I'm going to do that at the end of this video. And if that works, then we won't need to spend anything on compost. So we'll get all these potted up, and then I'll show you how we fill the trench in. Potted in, well, potted up. So now, like I said, all I'm going to do is just going to cover all the drainage hole with the soils that I've heaped up, so that they're all covered up, and that any roots appearing will just grow straight into the soil below, which then means they're going to get more nutrients. I did cover it. I did put a little bit of bloodfish and bone on that as well, so there'll be even more nutrients for them to get at once they grow through the pot and into the soil. So, like I said, I won't be watering these. These will just be left now, and they'll just get whatever water falls out of the sky until they start growing properly, that is. And then they do need a good lot of watering when they get to a lot of leaves on. But until that time, when it's still cold at this time of year, there's absolutely no need to water them. So what I'm going to do next is to try and find a way of growing some cheaper spuds without buying this compost, which is really expensive. I'm going to try and grow some in some molehill soil and sand. I'm going to do it exactly the same way, but I'll just show you the sort of stuff I'm going to be trying to grow it in. Right then, folks, this is the stuff. This is my own molehill soil mixed 50-50 with sharp sand. I thought it might be a bit too wet on its own. So I've mixed it 50-50 with sharp sand, give it a bit more drainage. So I'm just going to plant them exactly the same way, but I won't be topping these right to the top because it's so wet. I'll just top them up as they grow, as you would normally, and I'm not going to grow these in the ground either. I'm just going to see what they're like growing just sat on the floor, because then if I can grow some at home and they're all right, I'll do that. Oh, out of breath. Right, so what I didn't mention before is I grow my first earlies or second earlies, new potatoes, 3 to a pot. I would normally grow my main crop 2 to a pot, but depending on how many sprouts they've got, it's dependent on how many potatoes I'm going to grow. So if you look at these, they've only got 1 or 2 sprouts, so I will put 3 in a pot as I would with the new potatoes. But if they had lots of sprouts on, then I will be planting just 2 potatoes, but because they're pretty limited in the sprouts, then 3 will be going in. And again, the same way, there we got 2. put two different types in. That was very good. No, I haven't. So this is the Sarpos. Three in. Didn't even mix that up, and I'm just gonna cover these. I'm not gonna give them a really good filling, because like I said, it's so wet, this soil, it might rot off and before they get a chance to break surface. So we can top those up at a later date. So anyway folks, that's how I've plonked me potatoes in the pots, same as ever, but trying a different way this year with the sand. So that's about it folks. Spuds away. See you later.